Hello friends, this video on electricity and circuits part 6 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Okay, so now when we talk about glowing of a bulb, another important thing without which a bulb cannot glow is the electric cell. So everywhere we talk about the battery, we talk about the cell. So why is this cell so important? Now, everywhere we are talking about electric current, we are talking about electrons which are flowing through the circuit. But from where are these electrons coming? Who is generating this electric current? So the generation of electric current is done by the electric cell. So if there is no electric cell, there can be no current in the circuit. So electric cell, presence of an electric cell is very, very important. So let's see, what is an electric cell? It is a device that can generate electricity. So if you look at any battery, any pencil battery, you can take it out from maybe your remote or you can take it out from a clock and just try to observe it. What will you see? You will see that there are two ends of the battery. One end has a cap kind of structure like this and the other end has a disc like structure. And the cap like structure end has a positive symbol and the other end has a negative symbol which shows the positive and negative terminals of the battery. So now you might wonder that what is there inside this small cell that causes electricity to generate. So if you actually start looking at the internal structure or the internal composition of a cell, you will see that there are a lot of electrochemical processes, a lot of chemical reactions taking place inside the cell because of which these flow of electrons take place. Now inside the cell, there are two electrodes, a positive electrode and a negative electrode. As you can see here. So there is an electrolyte or a solution which contains charged particles, and because of the reactions taking place at this electrolyte, the charged particles flow from one electrode to the other, and this flow of charges constitute electric current. So that's how current gets generated within a cell. Now there are many different types of cells which exist. So you will learn about cells. When you learn about cells, that time you will get to know how different types of cells operate. So basically this is how cell is able to generate electricity. So when we often use the term battery. So how is a battery different from a cell? So when we talk about a cell, it is one single cell where you have one positive terminal, one negative terminal, and that's it. But when two or more cells are connected together, it forms a battery. Now, why do we need a battery? Now, sometimes the need of electricity is more. We want huge amount of electricity to be generated in a circuit. Now, one single cell might not be able to provide that much of electricity. So that time what we do is we combine a lot of electric cells to make a battery which will provide more amount of electricity. So it is something like this. Let's say you have a 10 rupee note. So you just have one 10 rupee note, but you want to buy a burger which costs say 50 rupees. So will you be able to buy with one 10 rupee note? No. Right? So what you need? You would need five such 10 rupee notes. So if you have five 10 rupee notes, so you will be able to buy the burger. So the same thing is true here. So sometimes the need for electricity is more and one cell cannot provide that much of electricity. So that is when multiple cells are joined together to form a battery. So how are the cells connected to form a battery? It is always ensured that the positive terminal of the cell, of one cell, is connected to the negative terminal of the other cell, and so on. So that's how the cells need to be connected. So we always need to make sure that the positive terminal of one cell is connected to the negative terminal of the other cell. So in this way, we can connect two or more batteries, two or more cells together to form a battery. So where do we use batteries? A lot of things around us where batteries are used. So some of the best examples are the torch. You switch it on and off and it just gives you light whenever you want. So there are batteries inside it. The remote, a lot of toys operate on batteries. Most of the toys which make some sound, which make some movements, they all operate on batteries. The dolls which dance and sing, they operate on batteries. So the inverter or the power backup, which provides us electricity when there is a power cut in our house, they also contain batteries. We have batteries in the engines of cars. You also have batteries in a lot of other vehicles. So batteries are something which are very widely used in a lot of devices.
Thank you. Please visit www.examfeo.com to watch more educational videos with a better experience. Please do not forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you once again.